So how are we going to do this with our HTML code? Well, we already know how to use the div tag, so we could use a div for each one of these sections. However, since we're new to HTML, why don't we do a quick search in Google to see if there's another HTML tag that might be better. So I'm going to do a search for HTML section. And at the very top here, we have HTML section tag. Interesting. So if we click on that, it gives us an example. So section in this case looks a little bit like how you might use div, and the description is a section in a document, and it shows an opening section tag, a heading and paragraph, and a closing section tag. If we scroll down, there's not a ton more information here, except that it displays as a block, and we'll talk more about this display property later. So if we want some more information, this is a good time to jump over to developer.mozilla.org. So if we click back and we click on the section on developer.mozilla.org, we can get a little bit more information about what this means. So at this point, we know that we can use section and we know that we can use div. So which one is the better option? So the details here might be a little overwhelming if you're not used to reading this, but it gives us some tips. So for example, if it makes sense to separately syndicate the content of a section element, use an article element instead. So what this means is that if there's a section of our page that's actually a self-contained article, that we shouldn't use section, but we should use article. And secondly, it says don't use the section element as a generic container. This is what div is for, especially if we're sectioning just for styling purposes. A rule of thumb is that a section should logically appear in the outline of a document. So in our case, our motivation is that we want to style this differently, but ultimately, we also want to separate out the sections of our document in a way where if we were to create an outline of our homepage, we would see separate sections with the different headings that we've supplied. So far, it seems like section might be the best fit. So we'll take that approach for now, and we can return to this later if we feel like section isn't the best approach. It's good to know that we don't want to use section just for styling purposes. If we scroll down to the bottom of this, there's this sections and outlines of an HTML document article. If we click on it, there's some good information here about why it is that we might use the section tag instead of a div tag. And there's a lot more examples here. Specifically, it shows us how this might have been done in the old version of HTML, HTML4. And we can scroll down to see what would happen in HTML5. And here's some examples. So here we have a section. And then within this section, we have a heading, and then we have sections within that section. Each section has a heading and some content, and if we scroll down, it shows us what the outline that would lead to would be. Now, at the very top of this page, it explains why this outline might be important, specifically that it might be used by screen readers. And it also notes that there's no implementations of this outline algorithm, which is what converts these sections to the outlines, yet. And so instead, it's more important to focus on your headings and making sure that headings are properly outlined, because screen readers and other technologies like search engines use those headings in order to create outlines and figure out what's important on the page. So the takeaway here is that if we used divs, it probably wouldn't be a big deal, but it still seems like the section tag is a little bit more descriptive. Now, there are a number of elements in HTML5, which is what we're using, that simply describe content on the page, and we'll learn more about that as we get into a deeper discussion of accessibility. But what they all have in common is that they work like divs in terms of styling. That is, they have no default styling. So we can do what we want with them and not worry about having to override existing styles in the browser. Phew,